What's good, everybody, and welcome to another edition of the Gaming Underground Podcast, where you get your gaming news and opinions from console gamers and
PC gamers.
Alright, now this one is a goodie right here. It's going to be kind of quick, but it was a lot to cover, and we're going to do this in a short amount of time. We just recently had the Video Game Awards and the PSX, the PlayStation Experience, happen, a couple of days apart from one another, so we're going to kick it off real quickly. Before I do that, though, let me introduce y'all to the co-hosts. The first one off to the left, the Michael Jordan, the gaming game fanatic. You thought I was going to say some smart shit, didn't you? 386, go ahead.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Hey, we're finally back. It's been almost 3 months, but we're back, man. A lot of news we got to cover. And we got to do it quickly because The Walking Dead is coming on. I ain't missing it.
All right. He calls himself the Michael Jordan of gaming, but he's more like the Smush Parker of gaming. So, all right, and my boy to the right, by way of all over everywhere USA, Stick Shift Willie himself, on the road, on location right now, Mercury 81. Say what up.
What's going on, y'all? I am officially not Stick Shift Willie anymore. I have my own truck now, and you can call me Automatic Daddy now because I'm driving automatic.
I ain't calling you that shit. that's
for the ladies.
I'ma just call you Merc, fam. I can't do that one, dog. Oh my god. Alright, hey, as always, everybody, links to their social outlets and stuff will be in the description. We'll try, and I repeat again, I will try to make sure this is up on SoundCloud. SoundCloud has been getting on my fucking nerves lately. I'm sorry for the language, but it has. That's why you haven't been seeing the last couple podcasts up. And like I said, it hasn't been a whole lot to talk about, but this one is, you know, it's kind of juicy, so we'll get into this. We'll kick it off a little bit like this. The VGAs, the Video Game Awards. We're going to get into the good, the bad, and the weird, and then we'll also talk about what game won Game of the Year and if we agree with it or not. Merc, we'll start with you. What was the good? What was the bad? What was the weird? And did you agree with the game that won Game of the Year, which was Overwatch?
The good was, you know, just seeing, you know, the few games that they did show, but it really wasn't that much, you know, to keep my attention. So pretty much the whole show was pretty bad. So I did see Uncharted 1 a little bit. Did any Xbox games any win anything?
Yeah. What was it? Best sports game or something? Forza?
Forza. Horizon, though. Was it Horizon or was it Motorsport?
It was Horizon.
It was Horizon, I believe.
Okay, alright, well, I can agree with that. But, with the Overwatch, hey, yeah, I'm glad Overwatch won that motherfucker.
Can you tell us why?
Because it's something different. So, I know everybody expected, you know, to see Uncharted win.
Thank God.
Huh.
Just something different. Like, Overwatch isn't like the game that usually wins, so it was something different for this year. So,
okay, I was about to say, because I don't know if you need to play Team Fortress or something, because definitely wasn't really a different type of game. But
I like Team Fortress too. Like, I'm just, you know, like, for it to be the game of the year.
So Merc is in agreement with Overwatch winning Game of the Year. Did you see anything that was cringeworthy, aka weirdo alert, going on during the VGA?
Just that dude that was all over Kojima. That was it.
Yeah, he was all on his nutsack. Yeah, we'll touch on that in a second. That it.
Yeah, that's all I got to say about it.
Nothing really too good. Everything was pretty bad and weird stuff.
I was very angry that I stopped driving to watch that.
Let's be honest, you did just like I did, Merc. You didn't finish it, did you? You didn't get all the way through, did you?
Yeah, I stopped driving to watch it, and to me, I hated that I did that. I lost money watching that bullshit.
Oh man, I'm sorry. I'm bad. Yeah.
What are you doing?
What do you mean?
No, man. Alright, what's your take on it, man? Good, bad, ugly tick. Good, bad, and weird, I mean. And did you agree with the Game of the Year?
Man, it was bad. Look, I don't like awards, like shows like that anyway. Like, I don't watch the BET Awards. I don't watch the MTV, whatever they call it, awards. Like, VH1, none of that.
All that shit,
yeah, I don't watch awards because, like, I just see it as a bunch of people that's more famous than I am winning stuff already that I can't win. They already winning. They still winning. So, like, I'm just be hating. But I watched it because the dudes I was in Discord chat, the dudes I played with every night, they were all watching it and everything. So I was like,
all right. The dudes you be playing H1Z1 with?
Yeah. So I was like,
oh, so y'all should be used to watching boring shit then.
Oh, you funny as hell. But anyway, so he took it to a whole nother level. I like it. But anyway, so I decided to watch it or whatever, and a lot of the people that won, like the game designs that won, I didn't think should have won, especially the game of the year. Definitely should not have won it, but hey, whatever. But The Witcher 3 won again, which is funny because that game came out 2015, but it still won, I think, best RPG game. Yep, Witcher won best RPG, so you know that's one of my favorites, so I like that. Street Fighter V won best fighting game. I was surprised. I thought Pokemon Tournament or something would have won it, but Street Fighter V was the clear winner.
Yeah, that game should not have won best fighter, yo. I mean, the game wasn't even a full game when it first came out. It took, 4 months for it to be a full game? Come on, fam. Let's take the fanboy voice out of it. Let's listen to reason. It
was solid from the jump, though. And I'm not a fanboy Street Fighter. You know that. I always played.
I know you're a Tekken guy, but I know you like that game. So we can't dismiss the fact that the game came out and it was incomplete. It's still incomplete if you ask me.
But
they ain't got some people in there that should be up in there, man.
He's funny. But anyway, I ain't paid full price for the game, so I ain't mad. I paid half of what the game was and got half the product, so I'm good. But anyway, I'm mad that the most anticipated game is Zelda: The Breath of the Wild, though. Kudos to Nintendo, though, man. Shout out to them for that, but definitely should have been God of War or Red Dead Redemption 2.
Oh my God.
Or maybe even Mass Effect, but I'm honestly surprised that that won that. To the weird. Okay, let's talk about the weird stuff. Okay, so weird is... Hold on, wait. I forgot. Best action game was Doom as well. Now, I'm surprised that Doom won. This was another overly hyped game. Like, I like Doom. Don't get me wrong. I enjoyed it. But I got bored of it pretty quickly. And that's why I stopped doing the Let's Play of it.
Doom was dope.
It was dope, but it was like, yo, I enter a room, hardcore rock music comes on, monsters start spawning, and I shoot them.
But you know what? I felt like that was somewhat of a hotbox. I'm glad you brought that stuff up, because I probably would have forgot to mention it. That game was somewhat of a hotbox win, because the music from the game, then they performed some of that at the actual award thing.
Yeah, they did.
So they just kind of like tied that into it. I feel like if they weren't performing there, that game probably wouldn't have won.
Right, because honestly, I think...
I feel like it should have, but it probably wouldn't have had they not had that group performing that shit. And that shit was like... They started going into that satanic shit and all that shit. I'm like, man, let me get my cross up, yo, and lead the room. This shit is weird.
I'm sure about like 90% of the people that was watching had seizures from all the lights flashing and stuff on the screen. Because I'm looking at it like, yo, I couldn't look. Like, I had to squint my eyes to look at it.
That shit turned into a mosh pit.
Right.
And was I the only one that felt like the Killer Mike deal was kind of like awkward as hell? Like,
weird.
I'm like, this was kind of weird, yo. Yeah, I'm like, crazy. Who's this dude performing with him? And like, nobody in that audience knew who the hell Killer Mike was. And let's keep it real. White folks can't groove to that shit. They be out there jumping around. We was laughing at that shit. I was saying that, you know, they dance like toddlers and shit. They just jump around. And that's what they were doing. So it's, you know. That's just what I got out of it.
I'm sure our white viewers will enjoy what you just
said. Come on, man. Let's just call it what it is. They don't dance to that music the way you're supposed to dance to that music. They dance to the same music, all music the same way. They just flail their arms and they just jump up and down.
Just keep
oh my God. Are you talking like all of them do the Carlton dance or something?
Just keep beating the flames.
You ever watched Charlie Brown?
Unbelievable.
You see how they all just jump around and that's how they was dancing, man.
Like my man to be
that's all I'm saying. That's all I was saying, man. That's how they was dancing. They would dance like the Charlie Brown character. They was just doing their own little just jumping and shit. I'm like, come on, man, what is this shit?
But nah,
this ain't the music to do that to. Like, they was still dancing like they was dancing to that Doom music and shit. I'm like, come on, it ain't mosh time no more, fam.
Yeah, I think the dude that was with him was the guy from like the karaoke cab driver or something like that. So it's a little.
I seen that shit. I'm like, damn, I'm like, damn, Mac Miller got fat as hell. I'm like, oh, that ain't him.
I'm done with you. All right, but yeah, I think Battlefield 1 against the War probably should have got best action game, to be honest. I don't know.
Action? Battlefield? Nah.
But, yeah, that's all this is action.
I mean, it's a lot of what's called, but I mean, action, when I think action, I think in like nonstop, just boom, 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 boom. I mean, Gears of War, I mean, that's a game. That's, you know, I love Gears of War. Battlefield, there's a lot going on. But it doesn't always. You don't always feel like you in nonstop action, because a lot of times you have to run a long way, or drive a long way, or fly a long way before you get it to it. What makes that game seem like it's so much action is that it's so many people there. You get what I'm saying? There's so many people there, so it seems like it's a lot going on. Whereas in terms with Doom, you basically out there 1v12, 13 at a time, where it's like boom, I gotta reload. Oh shit, boom. Oh, I gotta switch weapon. Bow. Oh, I gotta turn here. Bow. That's action to me. Is like, it's always something going on. You don't really have, you have to have quick reaction time to function playing that game. That's why I would classify action game.
I just wish Doom had better like the sound and the audio when I'm shooting the guns and hitting the launches and stuff. Like, it's not that much impact. That's probably what turned me off from it, but that's just a nitpick. Right. Anyway, games for impact. Okay, since we got an Xbox fanboy in here, I gotta bring this one up. Okay, so
who's that? Oh, Merc.
Oh, that's Merc. You're an Xbox fanboy. All right, so
Tyler,
you said you was the Best Buy, didn't you? You trying to take a kid's move, please?
I was getting bullshit, man.
Well, anyway, look. You remember the winner of that was that Dragon Cancer. All right, so it was like a little indie game made by a guy and his wife, who had a kid who passed away from cancer, and that's pretty much what the game was based on.
Oh yeah.
That was kind of sad.
Right, and he got on stage and cried. Now there was some tweets from some of these retarded Xbox fanboys that we know on YouTube.
Oh my god!
And they were savagely attacking the guy for winning, because I guess it's a Sony game only or something. I'm not sure. But they were like talking about him crying, laughing about it, and then
are these the same people that was lying about their house burning down and the other ones that make fake reviews and beg people for money and shit like that? If those are people we talking about, man, let's just keep moving, because them motherfuckers, they ain't got no credibility, man. Fuck
yeah,
that ain't no shit. That, I mean, it's one thing that to have this quote unquote console war, but that's some shit that you don't fuck with. That's like slander free. Like, at some point, man, don't be an internet fuck. You know what I mean? Don't be an internet fuck. You know what I mean? That was inspired off some real shit. And if you ain't ever lost nobody to that shit, I don't expect for you to understand.
Especially
until you do, you won't really understand. And then the fact that it was a child, and you making jokes and laughing at this dude because he got emotional about his inspiration, and you still sitting at home, or you know, in your mama's basement or wherever you stay, you know, on the internet, joking about that shit. I think that shit is extremely corny, yo. And I slap the shit out of any of them motherfuckers if I seen them in real life.
Oh, I'll follow up.
Fun of somebody.
I'll follow up after you slap y'all my run
and tell them and you can run and tell them that I said the shit and link all my shit and tell them come holler at me.
Yeah, all them motherfuckers fucked up.
Shit. Fuck them.
Like how in the hell you gonna just, you know, be laughing and stuff about real deal game that this guy made? Because, like, anytime somebody loses a loved one, like, you don't make fun of that, man. Like, it's supposed to be rules in this shit. Like,
I mean, like if somebody made fun of that whack ass shit that they dropped on Xbox, what was that bullshit ass game that too. Now, if that was based off some real life shit or whatever, and some real shit happened, or y'all wouldn't be joking about that shit. Like, I mean, they go on the PlayStation side too, because there's some idiots out here that back Sony and that's in this little garbage console war that they do. So, I mean, it's idiots on both sides, but they just take it to the extreme.
Take it to a whole nother level.
Yeah, they take it to a whole nother level.
Thank you for saying it. But let me end off what I was saying. Okay, so the last thing, the weird thing that I saw, though, bro.
We all know.
You know, I'm not even going to touch on that because we're going to touch on that later. But that was one of the weird moments. But not a weird moment was Death Stranding when we saw the trailer for that. And you know the Kojima game. And
yeah, did they ever announce when that game is going to actually come out though?
Nah, you're probably going to see that game for the next two years or three.
That shit ain't coming out to 2019.
I'm gonna be 40. But anyway, I don't understand what was going on in that game. It was just weird. But that's Kojima. You know, he's known for doing weird stuff like that. I just saw the dude from Hannibal just pop out of nowhere. And I don't know, man. I was lost that whole trailer. And I was trying to figure out the whole time during the game show, like, what could this be about? Like, I don't know. So that was one of the strangest. And game of the year, Overwatch. I saw it coming months ago because it got so much hype for this game. Now, look, I played this game, so you can't say I didn't play this game. So why am I hating on it? I didn't have much fun with the game. I thought it was boring. Like, it didn't feel unique to me. It felt like, you know, your Team Fortress, and I didn't like Team Fortress. I didn't like that game. So, of course, I don't like Team Fortress. I downloaded it, tried to like it, couldn't get down. It's just not my cup of tea. So I tried Overwatch because everybody was, you know, going nuts about it. And I played about five or six games. And like,
I remember watching you stream it, I believe. Didn't you stream it or something?
I did. And I couldn't get down with it. It just wasn't fun to me. Now, I'm not saying it's a bad game, but
how many characters did you try?
I tried the big dude that has that big shield that he pulls out. I tried,
tried Reinhardt.
I tried out Lucio, whatever, the dude that be skating and bumping music. I tried him out, and I was beasting with him because apparently the game is so easy where you just shoot somebody once and somebody else kill him and you still get the ward to kill. I tried out the little death-looking guy walking around like, die, Reaper. Die. Yeah, that
Reaper.
Guy.
Oh, yeah.
I tried him because somebody beasted on us. Yeah, Reaper. Yeah, so I tried Homeboy out, and then that was it. I ain't playing nobody else out.
Yeah, like, I tried it when I went home, too, and, like, my daughter, she's, like, a big Overwatch fan. And, like, I did the same thing. I went in there, I played, like, a few characters, and I hated that shit. Except she just told me that you got to find the right character and stuff. And she told me to try, like, Junkrat. I did Junkrat, and I tried the guy with the hook that had the shotgun. Mm-hmm. And those were the two that I liked. So that's why I started liking the game a little bit. So
I mean, Lucio,
you just got to find the right one.
Lucio was cool. Like, I enjoyed him because he was fast. He could wall run and all that. And I thought that was pretty cool. But the whole idea of the game and the mechanic of it, like, I just really, it wasn't nothing that, like, blew me away. And honestly, the real reason I think the game got Game of the Year is because it's a Blizzard title. Blizzard has huge fanboys. They can actually take a dump and then put it in a box and ship it out and just call it shit. The game literally can just title shit. And it will win Game of the Year. Like, it don't matter. So
I mean, I think that's a little harsh.
No, it's true, though. It's insanely true. There hasn't been one Blizzard game that really has failed. I don't know if I can call, like, one that actually failed.
I've heard nothing but good things about the game. So, I mean, I can't say that it doesn't deserve it. Because, I mean, you think about what else has come out in 2016 that's been, like, impactful. Or, basically, from a new IP standpoint. Because you have your Call of Duties, you have this, you have that comes out every year or every other year. And what has come out of nowhere and just said, oh, shit, people are still playing it and not tired of it. I mean, I think, what was the last game to come out of nowhere and everybody,
League.
You know, fell in love with it? What was it? Shadow of Mordor and Rocket League.
Yeah.
Those games, that, I mean, this is that year's game.
Why didn't they? Rocket League should have got Game of the Year because a lot of people played that over the game that won last year.
That came out in 2015, though.
Right, but The Witcher beat it. I'm surprised.
Yeah,
but it's the fanboys. Like, the game before it even came out was just hype. Like, everybody was crazy about it before they even got to touch it, knew about it. Like, you had so many people just wanting it. It was kind of like No Man's Sky because, you know, and I feel like No Man's Sky had so much hype because, one, it was a PS4 exclusive. Everybody was on that little fanboy PlayStation's better than Xbox stuff, so they were looking for that next new exclusive from Sony and a new IP. So they showed that game, and everybody was like, oh, this game looks amazing. And, you know, then they kind of fed them this bullshit as well while it was coming out, and then it just, like, overhauled it. And then when people got it, they found out it was a piece of shit. Now, you still got some people out there that still play it. It's still high up there, even on Twitch, and people still, you know, try to say it's good, but we know that shit's garbage. And Blizzard, I mean, Overwatch, man, like look at Hearthstone. Hearthstone is even a game that's like high on Twitch. It's normally number two, and that's another game made by Blizzard. And all it is a card game. So, like, it's just, if Blizzard puts anything out.
It's just a lot of people. Yeah, you're right. A lot of people support it. A lot of people support that shit. I mean, but then again, if the games are bad, regardless of what the title is on there, they don't mean shit. I mean, you put syrup on shit, they don't make it pancakes.
I mean, but there's games out there that me and you may not like, but people say it's like the best game in the world. Like, okay, Street Fighter.
It's a lot of. I mean, I can play the game Z1. And I deal with it. I can play it and I can deal with it. I just rag on H1Z1 because it just looked boring as fuck. But Street Fighter I actually own and I actually play that other shit. Like, I'm just not into that genre, like League of Legends or Hearthstone or like Yu-Gi-Oh, that type of shit. I don't play that shit. I'm not into it. I mean, I'm grown as fuck, yo. Same. I'm not into that. Like, if you got these 40-year-old man children out here that like that, that's up to them, yo. I'm not here to judge them or nothing. That's just not what I'm into. But I'm never gonna sit here and say, oh, fuck that game, blah blah blah. I'm just gonna say I'm not into it. I don't like it. So it wouldn't be my personal. That's why when we do our own game of the year shit, we do our own for our own personal preference. But for them, I mean, who are we to say? Well, who am I personally to say that Overwatch shouldn't have won it? Because if I can't name two or three other games that I felt was more deserving, then I don't deserve to criticize them for being game of the year.
Uncharted definitely should have won it, though. I mean, if you think about it, it had the whole package. It had Merc, a great single player. Dude. It had a great single player, and it also had a good multiplayer.
But still, like, you're still saying the multiplayer was ass. Come on now.
No, it wasn't that bad. At least
multiplayer was ass.
It was fun. It was fun at first. Man, you still ain't played that fucking game.
I have played.
I'm talking about me and you. I said me and you.
Oh, that's because you don't never be on when I'm playing it.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like that game was cool for the first couple of months, the multiplayer. Then they did something.
They did something.
I can't put my finger on what they did. They did something that just turned me off from messing with it anymore. I tried to play it like about a month ago. I was like, nah, fam, I'm good, yo. I heard they got new guns and all this. I'm like, yeah, they got new guns, but I mean, that's. You slap a new shiny coat of paint on a bucket, it's still a bucket. You know what I'm saying? If the thing can't get you around a corner, it don't mean nothing. It just look good going. You know, it look good sitting there.
Yeah, but you still got to look at the popularity of it too. Because if you still look on Twitch, what's one of the top rated games on there?
Overwatch.
But
it's a Blizzard game. It's like three Blizzard games. It don't matter.
If it's been popping.
What's the most popular game on Twitch?
League of Legends, Hearthstone,
Overwatch.
Paragon. Nah, not even Paragon.
Dota. Paragon is up there.
No, Paragon. Why not get up there? That's surprising.
Paragon is one of them games a lot of people be streaming and playing.
I'm looking right now. So
because I played Paragon.
Here's the first three right here. You got Dota 2, League of Legends, and shit, I don't got the thing playing. And Hearthstone are the first three. And then after that, you got World of Warcraft, a Blizzard game.
Oh,
so you got two Blizzard games right there next to each other. You got, I don't know what this, oh, the new game that's like H1Z1, which is Player Unknown Battleground. You got Smash Brothers. H1Z1 is number five. Overwatch is right behind H1Z1 and Counter-Strike.
Oh, my God.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, and even Destiny is right after Counter-Strike.
Destiny is still up there. Yeah, Destiny is still up there, though. That game ain't gone nowhere. Destiny is still up there. It's crazy.
See what I'm saying? Like, Blizzard games are always going to be up there. It don't matter. But the game is nothing really different. It's nothing that makes it stand out from other games. Like, I don't understand why people are saying it's so fresh. Like, what's fresh about it? It's the same.
Look what it did. Look
at it's a bunch of different characters.
Look at what happened to the game that came out the same time that did Battleborn. Who playing that now?
Yeah, and you want to know why? Let Battleborn have been had Blizzard. It'd have been the same game. Let them both have been the same exact games, but one had Blizzard under it. Which was Battleborn. Let that have Blizzard on his name. I bet you Battleborn.
Why can't the game just be good, though? I don't want to say the only reason why that game won it is because
get good, Scrub. Because he wasn't good at it. That's it.
That's all it is. Good at it. Get good, nerd.
You can't be bad at a game
that,
where
that was your main excuse for hating Gears. Gears. But that's and different. Now you done found out how to play Gears. Now you playing now Gears.
No. I admitted to being bad at Gears. I wasn't bad at Overwatch.
You didn't admit it until you then started playing Gears 4.
I've always admitted. I said the controls were tough, and I could always every time I would get banned from a room because I would like get bodied all the time. So that's why I said I hated Gears. But Overwatch, on the other hand,
they kicked me. They kicked me. So I hate the game.
Yo, y'all childish, guys. Hey, yo. Y'all childish.
Never forget.
But anyway, Overwatch. My problem with Overwatch is literally I just don't see why it's that popular. Like I said, I don't see nothing different about it. The game is extremely simple. That's probably why right there, because I know people are like a lot dumber than how they were back in the day, because you go back and play those Sega Genesis games when I do them Throwback Thursdays and I be getting bodied on like the second level of a Sega game. Yeah, that lets you know. So like people like the simplicity where all you have to do is literally shoot somebody twice and somebody else can finish off the kill and you still get awarded the kill. Like that's crazy. But like I said though, like just to shorten it, because we already went like 15 minutes on the same thing. I just felt that Uncharted probably should have won it just because it's a total package. Like, Overwatch does not even have a single player. Like, that's insane. And if Blizzard didn't touch the game, they definitely wouldn't have had this much popularity. Like, if you look at most of the streamers that stream it, like, females are normally on that sucker. And females pick all the games that they know got the most hype behind them that most people watch. So, they normally on Dota, League of Legends, Overwatch, and Hearthstone. And that's the most games you see them streaming on. And that's why they get on that Overwatch, because like it's just got a bunch of hype behind it, but it's really not that great.
But anyway. Still, like to me, Overwatch it has.
I ain't saying it's bad. I didn't say it was bad.
But I'm just saying, like you saying, it don't have a single player. But if you look on YouTube, they actually have like pretty much a cinematic about the game. Like it's telling you about the story of the characters. It's not like you're playing the game. But they're actually giving you the stories of some of the characters.
Still
don't
have a single player, though. It still don't got it.
It's still about the same thing. Like, you watching a cinematic about the game. Like, it's telling you about the game.
But I'm watching
like
a cinematic, though, and ain't single player, though.
It's just more into it than you know, you just saying that it's just...
Another game that I don't like, I still think should have ranked higher, and that's Titanfall 2. That even has a single player, and people say that was a real good single player. And the multiplayer is pretty Call of Duty.
Titanfall 2 is dope, bro.
Yeah, and that probably should have been Overwatch, but again, Blizzard.
We'll talk about that on the next one when we start going over games of the year, because, I mean, yeah, we'll talk about that.
Did y'all see the Zelda?
Yeah, he brought that up earlier.
I've been waiting for a freaking Zelda. And I was so disappointed because what they showed was like so like ashy and the frame rate was bad. Yeah. Like that shit hurt me, man. I was like, no. I said, why did they do Zelda? Like, but I'm thinking that it's probably gonna be better when it comes out, so.
Hey, the combat look good though, but I can't get down with a game if I'm hitting you with a sword and you're not bleeding. I'm sorry, I can't do it.
It's Zelda, man. Come on.
I know, man. But look, if Nintendo would have fought us with age wise, man, they could have added blood to it. They could have.
Well, nah, yeah. Make or it voice simple. Acting.
No, that's never gonna happen, Dad. Gonna...
I know. I just you know.
Just get ready for some more. Hey, listen.
It's not even that.
Hey, listen.
It's like a bling, and then like you gotta read whatever the hell is.
Ooh. Yeah, you know Nintendo ain't never cared about voice acting and shit like that. That's why they gonna forever be behind everybody else. Right. They still stuck in the 80s and 90s.
Okay.
All right, we done talking about the video game awards, because yes. Like I said, I didn't have a problem with Overwatch winning, because like I said, I can't name too many games that people are still playing.
Okay.
Still playing.
What about that man Boogie? Trending gamer.
Oh my god.
All right, that I was dude, savage on him.
That,
I'm sorry.
That dude stood up, boy. He stood up longer in that interview than he probably did in 2 months. Boy. I swear. I'm just saying, man. He seemed like he an all right dude, man. But I'm just saying, yo. You know, when they got to come to you, you know shit is tough. And that's how I was like, that's how you could tell it was kind of phony and shit, because you knew he was going to win because they was already over there standing by him. Like, right. It was no yeah. shock. I'm like, come on, fam. This shit a hot box. Because most award shows are a hot box, man, where the most popular thing won. That's why I was glad, you know, that Overwatch won it, because it wasn't the most popular, but, you know, it was something different. Like Merc said, it was different. I mean, you can only see so much Uncharted and all that stuff.
I'm glad it was at least Boogie and not Zoe Berger.
I would have loved it if it was Zoe Berger. I would have loved it. Especially if she would have twerked. I would have loved it.
I don't know. She got some new titties now, so.
Hey, man. She can get some booty injections.
I mean, she can change them titties all she wants, but she got to keep that fucking face the rest of her life.
All right, her face is not bad, okay? It's not the greatest, but it's not bad. It's
like Gargamel, bro. I'm straight.
Okay, you wildin'.
Let's move on. I mean, with a paper bag over the head, I'd hit. But
still wilding.
Like old Scary Movie. Keep the bag on. But, all right, let's move on and talk about the PSX, the PlayStation experience. We'll just go over what games impressed us, because it wasn't a lot going on during the PlayStation experience. So we'll just say what impressed you. Tick, what impressed you with the PlayStation experience?
You would ask the guy who was at work the whole time, though. I was hoping y'all were going to talk
watch,
to each other.
Did you watch the replay? All right, Merc. This guy's unprepared, people. Let's just move. Let's just keep it moving. Merc, what impressed you, Merc, about the PlayStation experience?
Well, I'm going to start off with the big one. The big one was the Uncharted DLC. I'm glad that that's coming out. So now I gotta hurry up and finish. It didn't say no date on it, but I gotta hurry up and finish playing Uncharted 4. The Last of Us 2. Oh my god! Woo!
Woo!
Can't wait! Yeah! Woo! Oh my god! I know they're gonna. I started crying like everybody. Now I was just playing.
I mean, hey, I ain't gonna lie. I heard somebody announce this game coming out and all this other stuff. Like, they had the inside scoop and they said that Ellie wasn't gonna be in the game.
Oh, nope, she's a main character.
I mean, somebody said that this girl and you know, somebody said she wasn't gonna be in the game. So
who the hell said that?
Punch him in his face.
I'll just say. You know, I don't give a fuck. You know, let's just say his name rhymes with Fable Lean. We'll just say that.
Maybelline.
I said Fable Lean.
I know who you're talking about, man.
All right, so we'll just leave that there for you to pick up the pieces. It's really simple. But, all right, what else, bro?
Let me see. Uncharted, Last of Us, and what else? It was something else that was. And Knack. Yeah, those are the main ones that I enjoyed, because I enjoyed Knack, so, and I know that I'm going to like the other two that's coming out. So, oh, and they are coming out with Parappa the Rapper.
Yeah, Parappa the Rapper. Oh yeah, I remember that game. Chop punch game.
Yeah, it was back when I was young though, man. That like took it way back. What, PlayStation 2?
Yeah, teenager. Yeah.
They got Ken Griffey.
No, that was PlayStation 1.
Ken Griffey. Is it PlayStation in the show?
Yeah. Yeah, that was PlayStation. That was PS1 game.
Oh yeah.
Oh god, I'm getting the show. They got Ken Griffey. Oh, that was one of my favorite games growing up.
Yeah, they got what they call it, retro mode or something like that. Yeah, he's gonna be on the cover of the next MLB The Show game.
I wonder if they're going to put Cal Ripken on it.
I mean, if they're going to have all them, if they're going to have old players and old teams, they better.
Then I'll
actually play the game for longer than a month.
If I can play right. Cal Ripken with you.
So, was anything that you didn't like that you weren't impressed by that they showed, Merc?
The Last Guardian.
Oh, my God. That game's not coming out. I'm backing like that game. That game.
It's coming out next week.
Is something gonna happen? That shit ain't.
I think next week.
No, nah, I'm just playing. No, nah, it's supposed to come out on the 6th. They said.
Oh, and they showed your boy Akuma. He looked like a beast, kicking ass to take your name. But
I heard a super song.
Oh, and they showed Marvel versus Capcom. And the thing I hate is they said that there would not be any X-Men. I was like, why?
I mean, you. I'll wait till you finish, bro.
How can you have Marvel versus Capcom without Wolverine and Storm, Cyclops? Like, oh my god, Magneto, like.
I don't think Dr. Doom either.
Honestly,
he's part of Fox.
Honestly, you just gotta accept it, bro. Because like they weren't gonna come out with a game in the first place because they lost the license because they couldn't, I guess, afford it. So they had to do what they could do.
So but it's still, wild. Like those are like the main characters that I like to play with was the X-Men and Deadpool.
Yeah,
another one ain't gonna be on there because he's part of Fox too.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like. That's like taking half of the game that I enjoyed.
Mm-hmm. I'm just waiting, y'all. I'm gonna let y'all get the shit off, and I'm say how I feel. This is crazy.
I think I'm ready now.
So what else? What else did you not like?
My main thing was just that, and that was it. But did y'all see when Yoshida came out?
Yeah. They were pumping him up, boy. He couldn't even talk. He was so geek.
I know. I'm like, no. I said, Yoshida probably pull down his pants. Every one of them go there and touch the ball. they love that man, though. But.
Oh my god! Super. All right, boy. Tick. What impressed you, man, and what were you least impressed about?
All right. So, obviously, Uncharted. I mean, not Uncharted. The Last of Us 2. So, everybody was speculating they was going to show it anyway. I kind of wasn't super surprised, but I thought they'd wait until, like, E3 next year. So, The Last of Us 2 is definitely, like, the biggest thing I saw on the PSX. I played the first one. I beat it. I didn't play it on the hardest difficulty like some of these guys say you have to. Fuck all that shit. I like to keep myself sane. Very fun game. So I'm definitely looking forward to the second one. It looks like Ellie's a little older. And apparently she's the lead character in this new one. So you're going to be playing more as her than as Joel. And probably, it looks like it's about 5 years later. So Joel is like probably old as, you know, old as dirt right now. So he probably can't do much, and he probably gonna somewhere get killed somewhere down the line in the whole game.
Man, why you
listening? Hey, man.
It's gonna happen. Man.
Don't talk about Joel like that, man.
You can't be Joel wishing death on Joel,
is the
bro.
Savage, man.
What does he have to do?
He is the original savage. You don't talk about the original savage like that.
He don't have nothing to live for at this moment. So
it's only 5 years, man.
He lost his little girl. She grown now, so he don't really have to watch her like that no more. He gotta die. That's gonna happen. I'm sorry. It's gonna
Ellie
happen.
Is his new girl.
But she grown now. She's 19.
Still, he's still gonna treat her like his daughter.
Yeah, but you know.
He's still gonna protect her, fam.
He is, but he gonna die doing it.
It's gonna come a place. You know what? I wouldn't even be surprised though, man. He actually makes sense, but I just don't want to hear that shit right now. We'll see.
But that
does make sense though.
Right. But that surprised me. Now I just looked at Knack 2 because you guys said I should go back and look at the thing. So I just looked at Knack 2. Now I'm surprised that somebody in here actually liked Knack because apparently everyone hated Knack. But you know, like I spoke about this a while ago when we had the PlayStation at my job. Most people would sit down and play Knack and would actually come back to the store, not to buy anything, but they would literally come back to the store to play Knack, and they would sit there for hours until they beat the game. Like, I'm not even joking.
Yeah, people, they hated on Knack and stuff. I think a lot of it was just the people just didn't play it. Because, right. Like, to me, like, I still like games like that. Like, me and my son, we played the co-op and stuff like that, so we beat it. I mean, and it, like, he got new moves and stuff, so...
Right, it looked pretty cool. I saw two people run on the stage and everything. And with the Pro, like, it actually probably run at like 60 FPS lock, depending, you know, if they allow that mode.
Yeah, because the PlayStation, it did have problems like playing it when you was in co-op with all those little particles and stuff. Mm-hmm.
So, can't keep up. Yeah,
that
game looked pretty nice. Now, Parappa the Rapper, I just saw that today, and I'm surprised that they had that up there because I never bought Parappa the Rapper. Because that was around the time where, you know, Tick was little Tick. Sus, that sounds weird. But Tick was a little Tick at the time. You know, he didn't have a job, so he couldn't go out and buy his own game. So he had to wait, you know, like Christmas or his birthday to get a video game. So, like, I never had the chance to get Parappa the Rapper on the PlayStation back then, and I always look back like, man, like that was a highly acclaimed game, and I never got to play it. So if they come out with the remaster of it, I'll actually pick it up and actually play it and see what everyone loved about it.
That was back in the day when we used to go to the grocery store and used to buy them magazines that had like the demos in there and stuff. It had that and Spyro up in there and all that stuff. I never had that stuff though.
Bro, I still got my original Sega Dreamcast demo disc, bro.
I do too.
I still got mine.
I got my PlayStation.
I still got my PlayStation 1 too, the one that had Lara Croft on it.
I think it probably had
some Tekken shit on there too. I still got that too somewhere.
Mine had Warhawk Game Day 95 and something else. Was it 96, 95, one of those two. And some
I think I got the one with Tomb Raider and it was some other shit on there too.
But, I remember I had to beg my mom to buy that one that had that crash and had that Spyro and the Parappa.
He keep calling me a Farrapper, though.
No, I don't know who I keep saying.
Farrapper.
But, yeah, so that's definitely one that I'm looking to pick up. Other than that, you know, like you said, they show Marvel. Now, I didn't like Marvel 3, so I really wasn't hyped for a new Marvel, to be honest with you. But then hearing the news about the X-Men not being on there, now I kind of have an idea why, but I think they should have just held off until they could, you know, get the rights to the X-Men. You know, work out some type of deal and then, you know, come out with it. But we don't know. Maybe because the game may not come out for like a year and a half or so. So they might be able to get the rights in there.
No, they put on that 2017.
I'll be gone. Well, maybe maybe by that time they might get, you know, something going and get them on there. We might be surprised. I don't know.
Am I lying? I could have swore I saw that at the end of the trailer of it. It said 2017, if I'm not mistaken. Mm. And then they went in and announced that 3 is available on the PlayStation for the PlayStation 4 now. Of course, you're going to pay an arm and a leg for that shit, but they ain't mentioned that.
25.
I ain't paying for that nonsense.
I ain't paying that bullshit. I got that shit on PS3 and I never played it.
On the PC, I'm tripping. But I ain't buying that joint, but forget that. But then, like, you only can have, like, 2-on-2, like, not instead of 3-on-3. Like, that was different.
I'm straight, fam.
Yeah, I'm good on that one a little bit. Other than that, I don't know what else they show other than like Crash Bandicoot. I didn't really like Crash Bandicoot back then. Like, I just saw that as like Sony's way of trying to compete with Nintendo's Mario 64.
Yeah, the old commercials. Hey, Plumber Boy, Mustache Man commercials.
Yeah, like
when he was outside of Nintendo headquarters. That shit was dope back then.
Yeah, but it couldn't compare. Like, it didn't do the whole 3D thing. It was still mostly a side scroller with like a 3D look, kind of like how Sonic 3D was on the Sega Genesis. Mm-hmm. Sega CD, which wasn't really 3D, so I passed on those. I really wasn't like a fan of like Crash Bandicoot, to be honest. So
true. All right. Anything that didn't impress you that you didn't like that you were like turned off by?
Again, the Marvel joint. Because when I first saw it, like you may have seen my tweets, I thought it was going to be like a mobile game or something like that. Because just the way it looked, like it didn't look like a top notch trailer. So. I just thought it was going to be like some type of mobile game we was going to be surprised by.
That shit going to get pushed back. That shit ain't coming out in 2017.
All right. The Last Guardian, not my kind of game, so I'm not really impressed by that game. Like, people liked Ico. So you thought H1Z1 was boring. Like, Ico is literally a boy holding a girl's hand and trying to lead her to safety pretty much.
I've played it before.
Yeah, so... I think I actually got the two-for-one disc, the two one
with that one and Shadow of Colossus.
Now that was good. Shadow of Colossus is good.
But dope game.
Yeah, that's Horizon though. That's what Horizon pretty much is going to be. So,
bruh, that I'm getting Horizon. I'm waiting on that game too.
Right. That's like that game right there is the only reason I want a PS4 Pro though. I just got to sell this basic one.
True.
I ain't trying to buy it and still have this one. But yeah. That game looked cool.
All right. For me, games that impressed me, of course, The Last of Us 2. I mean, the fact that they just announced it, of course, they didn't really show shit. Just, you know, them talking and stuff. But the game looks incredible, as always. I mean, the game was looked incredible on the PS3. So, I mean, that was one of my favorite games, probably, to date, was The Last of Us. The Uncharted DLC stuff with, what's the old girl name? What's that chick name again? Mert. I said, what's that bro name again from Uncharted?
Uh,
what the fuck, Chloe? Whatever her name is, the DLC they got. That was impressive. I'll probably check that out. Crash Bandicoot, I mean, just for nostalgic purposes, that was cool. It was cool they announced some stuff about Parappa the Rapper. What I wasn't impressed about was, I mean, I was and then I wasn't, was the Street Fighter V stuff with Akuma. Man, I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm glad they finally, even though he should have been in there in the first place, but that's another story for another day. And then they said 5 completely new characters. And I'm sitting here like, whoa. Completely new characters or new characters to this game from other games? And when they say completely, if they fuck around, yo, and don't put Sagat in this game, bruh, yo, Capcom is going to ban me on Twitter, yo, because I'm going to be coming at their heads every day, man. I'm telling you, bro. Oh,
get ready, dog. Y'all, they say new to bruh, the Street y'all, Fighter Universe.
They need to have Akuma on here. I mean, not Akuma. They need to have Sagat on here. If they just brought Akuma, Sagat should be next. Sagat should have been on there in the first place. The fucking Fang, yo. So, I mean, so that part, like I said, I was impressed by Akuma. He looked like he's just going to... If you get good with him, yo, he's gonna be a problem online.
Right.
And so I was impressed by that, but still unimpressed because they didn't put certain people in this game yet, and they haven't announced it. Marvel vs. Capcom 4. They don't have the rights to the Fox characters. I mean, you're not gonna see the X-Men on there, so how can you have a Marvel vs. Capcom game without Wolverine? Like Merc said, I mean, he's one of the originals. You gotta have him in there. You won't see a lot of characters like from the Fantastic Four. You won't see Deadpool. You won't see X-Men. So you won't see like Doctor Doom and stuff like that. So it's gonna be a lot of bullshit characters in this game. Real talk. That's just what you're gonna get. I mean, you only play with Captain America and Avengers and them guys for so long because they owned by Disney. So all those Fox characters, you won't see them. So where does that, you know? Because Marvel always had the better characters. Now it looks like Capcom is gonna run the table on that end, because this is gonna be a whitewash show. I don't like that one bit, and I don't think that game is gonna come out in 2017 either. So not. I was just highly disappointed in the announcement for that, especially when I heard that a lot of those Fox characters won't be in it, because the characters that's owned by Fox are the more, you know, the true comic heads. Those are the ones you ride with like X-Men and Deadpool and stuff like that. So
is Black Panther gonna be in this joint?
He better be. I mean, who else they gonna have?
Right.
They gonna be scraping for characters on the Marvel end now. Because you gotta think the X-Men is like the biggest group, the biggest faction. And they said they took all the mutants out, so you won't have like Sentinel in there. You won't have, you know, just a lot of people you won't have in there. So now you're gonna be, what I mean, is Doctor Strange part of Fox or is he part of Disney? He might be part of Fox.
I think he's part of Disney, I thought.
I don't know. I'm not 100% sure about him. So, I mean, but then again, a lot of people don't know shit about Doctor Strange. So, you're just going to be scraping. Like I said, Black Panther better be in there. You better be. Because I don't think I'm going to get it regardless. If they don't have the X-Men in there, I won't fuck with it.
Oh,
so.
I think Doctor Strange is Fox, bro.
Yeah, that's what I thought. So, yeah, man. So, once again, that's all I got for that. We can move on, talk on the last topic before we get out of here. Gears of War 4 just recently had their crossplay weekend. So if you were on PC playing on Windows, and if you're on Xbox, you could, you know, everybody was mixed in playing together. I played it for a couple hours on Friday night, and it ran surprisingly smooth. I mean, it was no issues. I mean, it ran flawless. That's all I can say about that. It ran flawless.
And the biggest thing was you didn't know who was on PC or Xbox, so you weren't destroying Xbox gamers if you were a PC gamer. So
yep. So because that's the first thing we thought. We like, man, we about to buy these Xbox dudes. And then you got on there, and it's like, okay, it's just open game. Like, we don't know who's who. It wasn't no icon over nobody's name to let you know what they were playing on. So, you know, it was just what it was. I thought it was going to be some hiccups in it, but I had zero issues in a couple hours that I played.
Right.
I might play that stuff again tonight.
I am. I'm gonna shoot.
Well, if I do, I'll get on there with you if I do.
Yeah, because I'm not like being able to play King of the Hill again, because PC gamers are fickle. I'm gonna come at PC Gamers right now because I'm a PC gamer. Y'all are fickle. I'm gonna say y'all because I ain't as fickle as y'all. They don't play but one game mode. Like if you even get on Black Ops 3 on the PC, they only play team deathmatch. They don't play nothing else. And it's the same thing on Gears of War. They just play team deathmatch, dog. And then they play it so stupid. Like they just sit there with Lancers, and you would have a whole team of Lancers and Retro Lancers just shooting at you the whole time.
Yo, that Retro Lancer is king, though.
Right, dog. And I'm like, yo, this is like the worst thing I ever played in my life. That's why I stopped playing it until they did this crossplay. Because I know the Xbox gamers are going to play other game modes, and it's more of them. And then they're going to, you know, actually use those Nashers. So, it was so much better. So much better. But, oh, and by the way, Doctor Strange is by Disney, so they might be on there.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, man. That if you haven't played Gears in a while, especially if you're a PC gamer, because I can understand why you stopped, get on there right now. It's a special game mode, though. It's like the crossplay game mode or something. You have to choose that. And it's just only for the weekend. Hop on there, and you'll find a match. Literally, it took like 6 seconds, and we found a match. And I was like, oh, my God, it's a blessing. So, yeah, hop on there. Definitely.
Yeah, that's the one thing I don't like about playing a game sometimes. It takes a long-ass time to get in a game.
Right.
A long time. Unless you do that social stuff, and you by yourself. But if you're playing it like with a full party, it takes a long time to get in the game.
Right.
Merc, any thoughts on Gears of War 4?
I really can't say anything about it because I just started the campaign and I'm trying to get past that first part because about to throw this damn game out the window by that horrible bullshit.
5.0 campaign.
Yeah. That shit should not be in that fucking campaign. I don't know who the fuck thought about that shit, but whoever it is, they need to fire that motherfucker.
When you run out of shit to do, man, that's what you know, you gotta keep the game moving, doing something. Like three different horde missions, you know, in the first two acts. That ain't where it's at. Right. Cause when you have to get that damn what's that damn thing called to do the weapons and stuff.
The replicator.
The replicator. You had to do one there too. So
yeah.
So yeah.
That part. So well, I just got it out the building. So now.
Since Merc didn't try it, I guess we can end it up. I'll just say once again. That Gears of War 4 crossplay was pretty dope over the weekend. It was nice as hell. It ran flawless. It ran smooth. Good job by Microsoft by making sure that stuff was smooth, because had this been a Sony PC thing or like something like that, that shit would have been laggy as fuck. I ain't gonna lie. So.
Street Fighter, what you mean?
What'd you say?
Street Fighter, alright.
You keep telling yourself that. That shit be like. That shit be lagging like a mug when you be playing. Against people. Yeah, that shit be bugging out. I know it does on me.
You need to start doing that more often, though.
I got to start back playing that game, man, and get good with Nash. When does Akuma come to the game, though? Did they announce when?
Sometime this year.
I don't know. I don't even care.
Man, give me a date, man. I can play with somebody else, man. I mean, I was getting good with Nash and all, but, you know, it's cool. All right, well, talk about what?
Jeff Keighley.
What about him?
From the thing?
Y'all was supposed to bring this stuff up.
I thought you wanted to talk about it like mainly.
No, I really didn't, but since you brought it up, you can.
Oh, no, I just thought that thing was funny, dog, because my man got on stage and was like, first of all,
I actually thought you were going to talk about when I said, you know, the stuff that was, we was talking about the weird stuff, and then when we said we'd get into what didn't impress you, I thought you was gonna keep going. But go ahead, tell him what you feel.
My man was a super fan. Like I feel like he wanted to marry that man, Kojima, dog. Cause like, hey, I swear that was the same trophy from the one from last year. I think he held on to that hope. He made sure that the place was set the same place that it was last year. And he just gave like this long drawn out speech of how he changed his life. He made his life better. He started tearing up. I think Kojima felt uncomfortable. I was looking at him. He looked like he felt uncomfortable a little bit.
Mean, scratching the back of his neck and shit like, okay.
Right.
This is awkward.
And like, hey, I understand if he was, you know, he was one of his favorite developers. Like, but I don't think I would ever, you know, go that wild about, you know,
big up nobody that hard, yeah.
Right, bro. Like, it's not.
There's one thing to feel that way, but I wouldn't say this shit publicly. I'd just be like, hey, look, man, this dude is my inspiration. blah, 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 and keep it moving. I'm not going to sit here and say, hey, I was going through a tough time. I was going through a tough divorce and all this stuff. But I just thought about how Kojima got through with his divorce with Konami, and it got me through it. Yeah, I'm paying alimony up the ass, but hey, I'm bouncing back. You know what I mean? I mean, who does that shit? Like, I'm not going to do that. So it's like, I guess, man.
But you like, know, he was uncomfortable though, because you know Japanese people, you know, they don't like show emotion like that. So
right,
yeah.
You know, especially in public.
And he definitely was uncomfortable. I was just looking. I was laughing the whole time, just looking at him.
Isn't Mia that every time the camera panned on that dude, he looked like he was off some type of substance every time they showed him too.
Oh, with his eyes red and stuff.
Yeah, he looked like he was all powder one time. Then he looked like he was hitting some type of amphetamines. I don't know what the fuck he was. He was just looking like he was on something, man, to keep him going. Each time that camera got on him. I don't know. He just looked like he was on something.
Shout out to Jeff Keighley though, man.
I mean, he seemed like a cool dude, man. He just always looked like he back there popping a couple pills or ODing on coffee or some shit, like after every set.
Right.
Like he gotta keep himself wired or something. Yeah, and then one time he looked like he was like dead ass about to fall asleep, like he was just sitting there and shit, and he talking. I'm like, is this dude about to fall asleep on stage or right here while he talking? And then he just went out and just yeah, and then it's like, all right, bro, you got it.
Downers kicking in, but yeah, man.
right. that was that 5-hour energy crashing on him.
But yeah, man, like I don't know. You would have thought Kojima really did get locked up and held like hostage by Konami the way he acted, though. Like he just got rescued. Yeah. But
hey, I mean, he bounced back, man.
Right.
He out here making these games. I mean, granted, that shit ain't coming out for another 3 years, but I mean, I'll be interested in it once I see more on it. Oh yeah, they did show some shit about that Mass Effect too. We didn't bring up. I'm not a fan of Mass Effect, so.
Me neither.
That Mass Effect Andromeda, that was during the Game Awards, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, they did show that. So we forgot to mention that as well. It dawned on me just a second ago. Merc, you a fan of Mass Effect?
Not really.
All right, fuck it then. Yeah, all right, y'all. Fan. So we about to be out. No fans of Mass Effect here. Hopefully the game actually comes out. They say The Last Guardian will be out by the time you watch this podcast. Godspeed, my people. Godspeed.
Don't you believe it.
We kind of forgot to bring up, you know, on Xbox now, if you have gold, you can get Sleeping Dogs, the definitive edition, and Murder Soul Suspect, so...
Oh, okay.
Wait a minute. Definitive edition? So why is it called a definitive edition?
I don't know, but still, Sleeping Dogs. That was like one of my favorite games.
So that's free. That's free on which card? I need to use that for my gold run out. I'm gonna have to download that. I gotta delete something though. I'm sure.
I'm on Sleeping Dogs on PC.
I still ain't played
Rise Son of Rome. Real shit. I still ain't took the time. And that game probably lasts about as long as this podcast. I'm almost serious it does. I heard this shit was short as hell.
It is. All
right, well, I guess we can wrap this up, man. We had about an hour. So, Tick, what is your closing statement, sir? What do you have to say to the people before we depart?
Hopefully we see you guys another week. Well, a week from now. Not a week from now.
Make it two.
Yeah. We're going to say 2 weeks from now. When we give you guys our picks of 2016, and you know, before we bring in 2017, the award show, like I said, I typically don't like them. Yeah, definitely don't like them after, you know, one game of the year that I definitely don't agree with. But hey, people like it.
Let it go.
All right, that's all I got. Fuck Overwatch.
Merc, what you got to say for the people, man?
It was good to be in the podcast, you know. Know it's been a while, but you know, a brother, he been trying to get his business up and running and stuff. But the thing I can say is, don't just settle for work for somebody. Go out there and make your own money, make your own move, be your own boss.
True. That's the best advice, boy. That's the best advice y'all can get, man. Real shit.
He ain't leave us with no coonish thing. I like it. Good job.
Yeah, man.
Hey, I'm on my I'm on my Anthropo Negro shit right now.
Oh shit. All right, your boy Vlock in closing would just like to say stay tuned. Appreciate first of all everybody that tuned in, whether you listen to it on SoundCloud or watching it on Tix channel or wherever you listening to it on. Also, we will be having this game of the year. We will do our best and worst games of the year for 2016 in a couple of weeks from now. Right before the end of the year, we give everything, you know, every game a chance. I still got a few games that I need to be playing. I still got to play Watch Dogs 2. I got it. I just ain't played it yet. And, yeah, man, y'all just be on the lookout for that, man. Ain't no stuff like that. No goofy stuff at the end, man. It's been real. We'll catch y'all on the next one. Gaming Underground. I don't know what episode this is, dog. I'm sorry. I have no idea. But on that note, y'all, we out of here, man. Stay up. Bless. Peace out.
Bye. This guy. What the fuck? And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to zip it and zap about that subscriber button and check out his past videos. Also, subscribe to his Twitch and follow him on Twitter. Duh.